But scientists weren't the first to discover the sixgills of Puget Sound. The initial sightings were made by a different group of underwater explorers.
The dive community has been essential to this research from the very get-go. They are our eyes and ears, and they're becoming, for us, citizen scientists.
The Northwest has some of the finest scuba diving on the planet, with one of the greatest concentrations of year-round divers. Cold Pacific currents feed this lush underwater world.
Well, every time we went out, we wanted to go a little bit further, a little bit further, a little bit further, see what there was to see.
Everything is just incredibly richly colorful and covered with life. You never know what you're gonna see.
We dropped down to about 120 feet. All of a sudden, we saw this huge, giant Pacific octopus coming along the wall towards us. And he looked odd. He got up close to us, and we realized he was missing all 8 of his legs.
And we saw a shadow coming from the shallow side, and my heart started thumping.
And all of a sudden, I heard my buddy suddenly going, you know, into his regulator, and I turned to see what was the matter with him, and there was a shark right here, coming right through the center of us.
And it looked like watching a truck go underneath me. They are the size of a great white, and I realized I'm seeing my first sixgill shark.
They're big. They're big sharks.
You're with an animal that, in some cases, twice the size of you, that if it chose to do so, it could take you out in a second and have you for lunch.
If I tell somebody about interacting with sharks right there in Elliott Bay, people are like, no, that doesn't exist. I go, oh, yes, it does.